So, hello everyone. I hope you're enjoying the webinar. Since Doug explained you the ultra-low noise comm on the previous slides, I will now show you the system in real life. So let's start with the optical components on the base plate. So here we have the figure 9 oscillator with the preamplifier. Beside this, we have the FT2F interferometer to generate our CO beat. And here on this side, we have a beat detection unit to generate a beat between our frequency comp and the ultra stable CW laser. Beside this optics, we also have an electronics rack. And there we have our PC, our laser and amplifier control, and our devices to lock the repetition rate and the CO beat. And finally, we have here our touch screen to where we can have our software to control the comp and also remote control of our locking devices for CO beat and the repetition rate. And we have here our USB RF spectrum analyzer and oscilloscope. So you can see your full comp here with the PC. So what do we see? Here on the upper left side, we have the free running CO beat, and here on the upper right side, we have the beat of the free-running comp versus our CW laser. And from this free-running CO beat, we can learn a little bit of the properties of our free-running comp. And to do so, we take this CW beat and give it to our high-level state-of-the-art RF spectrum analyzer and see what is the line width of our system. So because the CO beat gives us gives us the intrinsic line width of the system. And you can see here we have again a decent signal-to-noise ratio and on a logarithmic scale our beat. But to get some information about the line width, we change now to the linear scale. And you will see we have a span of 500 kilohertz. So this means one division is about 50 kilohertz, and you see that we have something around 25 kilohertz. So we know that our system has an intrinsic line width of 25 kilohertz. So what we now do, we now lock our system. So we activate the CO lock, and you see the CO is not free running anymore. It's locked to an F reference, and we will do the same for the repetition rate. We activate the lock, and now our comp is fully locked to an F reference. And so let's therefore have a look at our CW beat. As you remember before, we saw the CW beat between our comp and the ultra narrow CW laser. And again, what you see here, this is the CW beat, and it's quite stable, so it's not changing its frequency because all of our comp lines are locked, and so there will be no change of the center frequency. And again, you see the frequency, you see the line width, which is around the 25 kilohertz. And this is, and in this configuration, you can do a lot of different measurements, like measuring the CW frequency. And but if you want to reduce the line width, you can also apply the optical lock. This means we will not lock our comp to our F reference. We now will profit from a good CW laser and lock our comp on this system. And to do this, it's quite simple. We unlock the system, we load the optical lock settings and activate the lock. And then we see that the line width shrink down to, yeah, that's a good question, to what? So let's have a closer look here. We again go back on the linear scale, and we have again the span of 500 kilohertz, and we see here that we have a resolution that we are limited by the resolution of our spectrum analyzer. So let's increase the span. Let's go down to from 500 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz. And then even we see here that we are still limited by the resolution of the spectrum analyzer. So let's go further down. Let's go down to 1 kilohertz. But again, the same situation. So let's go down. The lowest possible resolution here is down. Let's go to 10 hertz. And then even here we see that we are limited by the resolution of our F-spectrum analyzer. And this means with our, when we're locking to an optical reference, we can achieve that every comp line has a sub-hertz line width. And our frequency comp is now optically locked. And the next step we want to do is to find out the signs of the CO and the CW beat. And we can do this during the optical lock. To explain this, I will use our ultra-stable CW laser and our frequency comp. During the optical lock, we have two fixed points. One is the CO beat, and the other one is the frequency between the ultra-stable laser and the next comp mode. Here you see that the CO beat is at 35 MHz, and also the CW beat is also at 35 MHz. So what we will do now is that we increase the lock point from 35 to 36 MHz, and if the CW laser would be here on this side, you see that the 35 MHz increase, and you see how the repetition rate would go down. If it would be on the other side, then we would have the 35 MHz increase it to 36, and then you see how the repetition rate increases. So by changing the lock frequency between the ultra-stable laser and the next comp mode, we can identify by looking at the repetition rate if we have a positive or a negative CW beat. And so this is what we now do. So we have here our optical lock. We go to the synthesizer, go to the 35 MHz, and we now increase the lock frequency. And if you look at the repetition rate here, we see that the frequency is going down. So this means we have a positive CW beat. Then we go back, and you can also see, then let's do the same for the CO beat. Go to the synthesizer, go to the 35 MHz, change the frequency, increase it, and we also see that the repetition rate is going down. So this means we have also a positive CO beat. And due to the behavior of the actuators, we know we also set our settings in the lock devices that way that it just easily can look at the sign here of the locking electronics. And to find out the CW beat and CO beat, you don't have to do any determination. You just look at the home screen of your locking electronics, and it tells you that you have a positive or negative sign of the CO or the CW beat. And since we now know how to determine the sign of the CO beat and the CW beat, the next step will be to determine the mode number. To do so, we need to do two or more measurements. So let's start with this first set of measurements. So we have now the CO beat and the CW beat locked, and let's now measure the repetition rate. For this, we can just open our recording software, start a measurement, and measure roughly 30 seconds. Okay, so the first measurement is done. And to get a second measurement, we must now change the repetition rate. And to change the repetition rate, we will first unlock the lock to our optical reference. We will then move the stepper motor by 20 steps. This changes the repetition rate of our frequency comp. And then we will activate the lock again, and then we have our second set of measurement. And again here, we will make, you can also see that the repetition rate changed, and now we make a second measurement. And again, wait 30 seconds. Okay, so that's the second measurement. And as I told you, there would be more measurements would be nice, so you can repeat a third, fourth, fifth measurement by strongly changing repetition rate. We have done this, and now we have the three set of measurements, and then we can use our mode number finder and to enter these values, and then we will get out the CW frequency of our CW laser and also, of course, the mode number. So we have this script here, and I will also record this window when And so you see we have three measurements. So the first measurement we already typed in, and for the second and for the first and second one, we still have to enter the values. So let's record this one. Then we have our first measurement was measurement one, and we have here our first repetition rate we have to enter. The good thing is, since we know that our CO and CW, they were locked to 35 megahertz, and we know that we had a plus, so we don't need to care about the CO and optical beat frequency. We just have to enter the frequency here. So that's for measurement number one. Then let's go to the second measurement, load measurement number two. And so here we have the second repetition rate average. So we have typed in our three sets of measurement. The next thing is, so we know roughly the frequency of our CW laser. It's here 1542.1 nanometer. And if we say it is in terahertz, it's 194.4 terahertz. So our search range is plus minus 100 gigahertz. And the assumed optical precision is how strong would the CW laser drift during the measurement. Here we have an ultra-stable CW laser, so it won't drift very much. So therefore, we have now set all parts here. We can press compute. And then we see we get different solutions. And you see the probability here is close to one. The other one are by 1%. So here we can find out our mode number, 777606. And our optical frequency is 9194.4 terahertz and so on. And here from the DF max, we know we have something like 13 kilohertz deviation.